Good morning, everyone. This is Dill Hero. I'm joined here with Mr. Whistler, and you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs live from Cleveland, Ohio, brought to you by Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Burning River Roller Derby. Today, we're about to see a matchup between Jet City Roller Girls and the Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Jet City's from Everett, Washington, and right now they are ranked 57 in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, putting them in Division II, and Team Oklahoma Victory Dolls are hailing from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and they're ranked 58 and here in Division II. Very close rankings, Mr. Whistler.
Yes, indeed, Dill. And right now, let's take a moment to talk about the roster matchups for this game. I'm going to lead off here with Jet City from Everett, Washington. They will be skating in blue. Number one is Sia Wouldn'twannabia. Number 10, Ellen Z. Number 11, Star Tarriot. Number 12, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Number 13, Ava Durchi. Number 15, Ill Ninja. Number 19, The Mexorcist. Number 23, Afraid Not. Number 3, Chicklets Rock. 31, Chantilly Cream. 39, Whoa Nelly. Number 41, Assaulted Peanut. 44, Sangria. Number 5, Ivana Hercha. Number 6, Razor Wrecker. And number 80, Beethoven's Fist. Trailer Trash will be working the bench for Jet City.
All right, and the Oklahoma lineup for today in red, 00 Mount Crushmore, number 11 Jenna Tees, number 12 Check 1-2, number 14 T-Pain, number 21 Ace of Spades, number 28 Lethal Lamb, number 42 Scar Bomb, number 46 Fatal Inferno, number 6 Rachel Coffey, number 777 Dispenser, number 82 Menace, number 85 E-Bomb, number 928, Dita Von Casualties, and number K0, Polly Punching Pocket, and Shooter Strychnine on the floor with them today.
And a quick run-through of the officiating roster. The head referee for this game will be Matt S. Faction. Inside pack ref is Laddie. Jammer refs are Julius Seizure and Professor Murder. OPRs are Jules and Regulations, Freddy Mercenary, and Z-Dork. And of course, since we are in Cleveland, Ohio, Dill, our alternate official will be Cleveland.
Cleveland overall. Well, here we are on the start line, getting ready to start up right now. In blue, once again, Jet City Roller Girls, number 13, Ava Durchi. On the line, in the red, Oklahoma Victory Dolls, number 46, Fatal Inferno.
That's right, and we're just about ready to get underway. There's that start whistle.
And the Fast Girls start line is ready for some action as we are getting it underway right now. 46 pushing her way up to the inside of that pack. 13, Ava Durchi, held back in the back of that pack by Oklahoma.
Yeah, Ace of Spades doing some nice work there right off the line, holding back the Jet City Jammer, Ava Durchi. Almost through is Ava Durchi, but does actually get through, but that is not, she's not being given the lead jammer status, so that is still up for grabs. Stale Inferno working her way up towards the front. Hits the deck, getting a hard hit there from number 15, Ill Ninja, pivot for Jet City. Finally, lead jammer status awarded. It took almost a minute. Sorry, that was a scoring pass. The first 5 points of the game going to Jet City. Ava Durchi rides inside line, picks up another 4 spot.
Actually, 5 spot right now. Jet City sitting at 10. She pushed through the inside easy and fast. Right now, back up in the pack with the blocking going on. Number 46 out of that pack on her scoring pass, 4 points for Oklahoma. And Fatal Inferno running into a little bit of nasty Nikki Nightstick. Not a place she wants to be. Knocked out to the outside, sent to the penalty box for a forearm block, it looked like.
So right now, that means this is a power jam for Jet City. Jam running out, so it looks like we probably will have a power start for Jet City on the next one, as Fatal Inferno is sitting in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Conclusion of that jam. Both teams score. We're off in off to the races here. 15-8 for Jet City after one long jam to get things underway.
Well, off to the races they are. Whoa, Nelly, as it were, number 39 for Jet City on the Fast Girls start line.
And Fatal Inferno starting this one in the penalty box.
Whoa, Nelly making some quick work of that pack immediately outside of turn one as the lead jammer for Jet City in blue. Right now we're sitting at 15-8, 27 minutes and change left in the first half of this bout, and she is back around in scoring position. The three wall trying to upset that scoring position, knocking her to the outside, recycle to the back.
Genetes and Menace at the epicenter of that tornado of blockers. Finally have to let her go. 5-point pass there for Jet City. Fatal Inferno is going to return to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, this time for a track-counting penalty. Another power jam here for Jet City, Dill.
Well, Mount Crushmore with a devastating hit right before that happened, and here we are right now, number 39, Whoa, Nelly, once again out of the pack outside of turn four. She has 5 points for Jet City. Jet City setting a standard here at the beginning of this bout, very early in this bout.
Rydell skates are made in the USA. They are made for Derby. Rydell skates, RydellSkates.com. And this is game two here at Cleveland of the 2015 International WFTDA Division II playoffs. Earlier today, we've already had a close game. 10-point victory for St. Chuck's over Brandywine.
And here we go. Once again, Jet City in a power jam situation coming off of the Fast Girls start line. Oh, number three with a high block sent to the penalty box. Low block.
So jammer do-si-do. Fatal Inferno back out. Third jam in a row has not been able to get rid of that star, unfortunately. Direction of gameplay penalty being issued to number six, Rachel Coffey for Oklahoma. And another jammer penalty on Oklahoma. Again, Fatal Inferno track cut. Ready, third jam, third penalty for the Oklahoma jammer.
Well, and if this time runs out like it did in the past two jams, she'll be jamming again.
Nice move up the outside there by Chicklets Rock. Jammer for Jet City. Driven outside. No pass, no penalty. That completes the initial.
Here we are. 4-on-3. Jet City strong in the pack with four. Oklahoma with three. Chicklets Rock making good on the outside. Passing through for 5 points. Five more points for Jet City, bringing them to 30. Right now, Oklahoma still sitting at 8.
Fatal Inferno trying to take the inside line. Finds that door shut, has to go back and reset. Now working, trying to get around a nasty Nikki Nightstick, number 12.
All right, so right now Chicklets Rock took a nice hit on the outside of turn four. And that star helmet cover had fallen off. She did not recognize it. The pivots picked it up right now and handed it back to her.
Yeah, it was Sia Wouldn't-Want-To-Be-A with the good eyes there to see that star.
Immediately, Oklahoma swarmed around that and had a good stance around it, trying to kind of block view but not touch it, of course. That could have been pretty bad for Jet City right there. One more point. Right now we're sitting at 31-13, 23 minutes and change left in the first half of this bout. Jet City in the lead in blue, Oklahoma in the red.
That's right, and Oklahoma now able to finally get a new jammer on the Fast Girl start line. Number 12, Check 1-2, facing off against number 5, Vanna Hercha, wearing the star for Jet City in blue.
Check 1-2 immediately running into a solid wall. of Jet City defense recycled to the back on the outside. Meanwhile,
and right now you're seeing both teams splitting into two four tornadoes. These are level fours happening right now. Jammer breaking through for Oklahoma, and that's check 1-2.
No pass, no foul, not lead jammer. So that lead jammer stat is still available for Jet City. All they got to do is get out of that mess of blocking.
Another jammer penalty on Oklahoma, this time going to check 1-2. Again, a track cut. Out of play penalty being issued to number 00. It's Mount Crushmore for Oklahoma, the pivot. So they now have both their helmet covers in that DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Ivana Hirschi making quick work of that pack. Five more points for Jet City. The pack at a standstill between turn two and three. Pushing out. Oh, look at that. Number 11.
Now, Genetese laying the body. Down at turn three, Ivana Hercha, number five, calls it from the outside. Just as that jammer penalty to check 1-2 expired, so they're going to send out number 14, T-Pain, to the Fast Girl start line. Against number 13, Evaderce for Jet City. 4-3 pack advantage right now for Oklahoma. I know there is a fourth blocker. Oh, sorry, it's a 3-3. And the blocker standing in the box. Nasty Nikki Nightstick. She's like making her go around, take the long way. She does, picks up lead status for Oklahoma. That's T-Pain.
T-Pain now on her initial scoring pass. Quick work through the pack. Well, getting sucked back into it. And there she goes, out of that pack. 5 points right there for Oklahoma City.
Oklahoma City now has a power jam as a track and a penalty was issued to Evaderce, the jammer for Jet City. The big opportunity for Oklahoma to close this gap right now down by 21 points. T-Pain has to go back through the infield to re-enter.
A nasty Nikki Nightstick trying to shut it down. Suffering the penalty for it. Sent out to the box. And right now we got five more points for Oklahoma. Oklahoma closing the gap.
Menace and Mount Crushmore up front. Last one to beat there for Evaderce. Unable to complete that pass. Three more points, though, come in for Oklahoma. And yes, indeed, Dill, they have narrowed that gap down by 11 points. And don't forget, if you are on the Twitters, you can get in and communicate with us using the hashtag #TalkNumber2WFTDA. It's the #Talk2WFTDA hashtag. Also, follow along at WFTDA Live on Twitter.
Whoa, Nelly returning to the line for Jet City with Polly punching pocket for Oklahoma. And Polly punching pocket, punching a hole through that pack, and she gets through. That's a lot of peas right there. And she is the lead jammer, tongue twister morning right here.
Star Sash, star goes back on the helmet of Whoa, Nelly, number 39. And another jammer penalty to Oklahoma. Wow. This time a forearm being issued. Forearm penalty being issued to Polly Punching Pocket. Power jam in favor of Jet City and Whoa Nelly, who just like that puts up five big roller derby points.
Right now that puts us at 45-29. Jet City still holding the lead. 18 and change left in the first half of this bout. Right now Whoa Nelly re-engaging the pack right inside of turn two. To let her go. There it is. Five more points for Jet City.
Another penalty being issued there to Nasty Nikki Nightstick, and she's going to return to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Well, Polly punching pocket, returning back to the track a little bit earlier, now getting 4 points on the board for Oklahoma City. Meanwhile, right behind her, Jet City, Wonelli with another 4 points for Jet City.
Well, Wonelli already taking over the scoreboard here in the early going. Hits the deck, has to reset, now has four red blockers to get around. Tries to take the middle and thread that needle. Door closes, getting some help there from Beethoven's fist. Does pick up two more points. 4 points come in on that jam for Oklahoma. It's 56-37. Right now, but like I said, Wonelli already in the early going, a leading scorer in this game thus far. After two jams, she's put up 26 points for Jet City. On the other side of the dial, Oklahoma, two jammers, both sitting at 13, both T-Pain and Fatal Inferno.
Chicklets Rock on the line right now for Jet City. And number 28, Lethal Lamb. I believe it's her first time out on the jammer line for Oklahoma. And Chicklets Rock out of that pack. She is the lead jammer. Jet City once again controlling the jam.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick laying the body, and that's going to earn her a trip to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Third trip in as many jams.
Chicklets Rock with another 5 points for Jet City. The pack is getting thin. We've got a 3-on-2 pack. Oklahoma's favor.
Chicklets Rock was trying to call the jam. However, same moment, jammer referee Professor Murder was issuing a forearm penalty. She's going to take a seat in that penalty box. Power jam pendulum is switching in Oklahoma's favor.
Right, and right as that penalty was assessed, that gave Oklahoma the chance to score 5 more points real quick. And another 5 points for Oklahoma for a total of 10. And by the time I get done talking about it, bringing them to 47. Jet City 61, still a very close game. 15 minutes and change left in the first half. Lethal Lamb right at the front of the pack. We've got a 3-wall of Jet City trying to shut her down and holding her at bay.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick, last one to beat, has to let her go and does.
5 more points for Oklahoma. Chicklets Rock return as jammer for Jet City. Sticking around in the back of the pack, waiting for the whistle to call. The jam comes to an end. 52 for Oklahoma, 64 for Jet City. 15 minutes left.
Adam Skates, train hard, play smart, skate Adam. Adam's a proud partner of the WFTDA then and now. AdamSkates.com. So at that last jam, Lethal Lamb, now the leading point getter thus far for Oklahoma, having put up 15. Officials calling a timeout on the track. Matisfaction having a quick word there with Trail of Trash from Jet City.
Yeah, we're sitting at a timeout right now. 64-52, Jet City holding the lead from the beginning, but Oklahoma close on their tails. Like I said, 64-52. 14 minutes, the clock is still 14 minutes, 40 seconds left in the first half. Oklahoma is being riddled with jammer penalties in the beginning of this contest.
Yes, indeed, that has been the story thus far for Oklahoma. No history between these two teams. This is the first time they are facing each other all time in sanctioned play.
Sitting in a timeout. With 64-52, like I said before, Oklahoma with a lot of jammer fouls, but still holding the score pretty close to Jet City.
Yeah, Lethal Lamb ordinarily seems to be used mostly in a relief jamming position in the regular season. Has already scored more points than during some of those opportunities earlier in the year. So turning up right now for Oklahoma. But right now coming out the Fast Girls start line for Oklahoma is number 12, check 1-2. However, it is Ivana Hirsch, number 5 for Jet City in blue, who's got the lead status just past the halfway point of the first half of this game, Dill.
Right, here we go. Check 1-2, making it out of the pack. Meanwhile, Ivana Hirsch coming out of the pack with 4 points for Jet City calls it off.
And if you're listening to the free audio coverage this weekend, it's not too late to get the high-quality video feed. It's just $12 for the weekend. Make sure you're ready to follow the battle for the Hydra every step along the way. Get your Division I playoff viewing passes now at WFTDA.tv. They're just $15 per weekend or $60 for all four Division I playoffs and championships.
On the Fast Girls start line right now, we have number 14, T-Pain from Oklahoma City, and number 13, Eva Durche from Jet City.
And Menace being one with the takeout there on Evderji, taking her back to the start line. T-Pain trying to get around Chantilly Green.
Eva Durche sliding in on the inside, found a little bit of a tunnel, got through, and she's the lead jammer right now, Jet City.
T-Pain, though, only about a quarter lap behind. So Oklahoma's setting up at the front. Going to make Ibadurche work for these points. Ibadurche getting a little push there from Star Terriot. A little too heavy on that push, unfortunately. She hits the deck and has to call it. So a couple of donuts go up. No points on that jam. Polly Punching Pocket, number KO on the Fast Girl start line. And Woe Nelly, number 39 for Jet City. Wonelli still thus far the leading point getter for Jet City.
Well, Jet City sitting at 68, Oklahoma 52, 12 minutes, 25 seconds on the clock. And the jam is underway.
And this one already shaping up to be yet another barn burner. And Polly Punchy Pocket's going to take Wonelli all the way back, waiting for the pack to catch up and see if they can get her absorbed. And they, does. Haven't seen that move pulled off lately. Nice move there by Polly Punching Pocket.
Yeah, it worked effortlessly. Knocked her to the outside and run her all the way back into the pack, and now she's stuck in that pack. Meanwhile, Polly Punching Pocket on her point pass. Oh, cutting the track right now. That's going to make this a power jam. Cutting the track, going to Woe Nelly. Beethoven's Fist joining her in the penalty box right now. We have lead jammer, Polly Punching Pocket.
Yeah, it took a while for that lead status to be issued.
Yeah, there was a lot of territory on that track to re-engage the pack after she took it all the way back to the beginning. Five more points for Polly Punching Pocket for Oklahoma. Now we're sitting 57-68 as this jam is in play. Polly Punching Pocket punching her way right to the front. Last line of defense, number 41, Assaulted Peanut. Another 5 points for Polly Punching Pocket. Oklahoma, now we're sitting 62-68. Things are getting close.
They are indeed. And the jammer penalty to Woe Nelly has expired. Back on the track in the pack. Everything tightens up, so even when you get a no pack call, they reform so quickly, it's not enough to spring either of these jammers.
Sangria with a little bit of a knockdown right there from two Polly Punching Pocket. Out of play.
Almost had a star pass there at the end. Came off, but not in time to do anything with it, as jam did get called by Polly Punching Pocket. But ladies and gentlemen, we are now down to just a 3-point game with 10 minutes left in the first half. Jet City in blue in front, 68-65.
Wow, Oklahoma's really getting their skates underneath them. Not as many jammer penalties in this second part of this first half. We'll take a closer look at it later. Right now, though, we're at 65-68. Like you said, this is a very close game. Oklahoma inching back and closing the gap. Chicklets Rock for Jet City and Lethal Lamb for Oklahoma representing Jammers. And right now, Chicklets Rock getting out of that pack as your lead jammer.
Out of play penalty being issued there to the pivot, Ill Ninja, number 15 for Jet City. Going to take a seat in that DerbySupply.net penalty box. And also taking a seat is the Jet City jammer, Chicklets Rock, for a forearm penalty. So just as we say that the jammer penalties have eased up a bit, there's a couple right there for you.
Yep, well, that's on Jet City this time, though. Oklahoma still holding strong with Lethal Lamb as the jammer. But we're seeing a two-on-three advantage to Jet City pack, but she still makes her way through with five more points for Oklahoma City. And right at this second, we just had a lead change as the momentum is pushing Oklahoma City past Jet City by 2 points. The jam is still underway.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick taking her fifth turn in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Things slowing down here at turn three. Chicklets Rock trying to get around this triangle of red. Des Dispenser trying to do the drawback, not in time. Chicklets Rock does spring free, puts up 4 points. Star pass in progress for Oklahoma. Handed off to their pivot, number 85, E-Bomb.
There we go, E-Bomb now, representative of the jammer. That'll end this jam with 4 more points for Jet City. Another lead change now. Now we have a game, the back and forth with 2 lead changes in the past few minutes.
And an official review has been called by Jet City. So we'll get some information on that shortly. We also will have head referee and Mattisfaction delivering it the news in-house, but we'll also see if our producer Lightning Slim can run down and get a little more information. In the meantime, I'd like to just quickly tell you that Sin City Skates, we do not sell it if we wouldn't play in it. The best, the first, happy to fix the rest, SinCityskates.com.
So discussing the official review on the floor, Jet City and Oklahoma have never, ever played each other before.
No, first time for everything.
Yeah, right here, Division II in Cleveland, Ohio. The 2015 International WFTDA Division II.
Mm-hmm. And, I mean, Jet City this season, only with 4 sanctioned games under their belt, actually looking for their first sanctioned victory of the season as well, but did play some higher-ranked opponents earlier this year in April, dropping a 102-point deficit to Ole. Number 15, Rat City, took them in June by 166 points. That's relatively respectable, I would have to say, against somebody who is up in the top 20. So they haven't been far off the mark. And looking right now, like trying to get some control back here, it's still a 3-point lead for the Bombers.
Yeah, after two quick and fast lead changes. 7 minutes, 47 seconds left in the first half of this exciting bout.
And Lightning Slim, what's the update that you have for us? So confirmation that the call stands on number 11, Star Tarriot for Jet City. That is Star Tarriot's 6th trip to the box. So already in danger of the first foul out of the game. Still have 7.5 minutes left on the period clock.
Well, here we go. Number 12 for Oklahoma. E-Bomb is your lead jammer. Oklahoma wanting to take that lead back, obviously, and she is around that track in the passing position. Meanwhile, Ivana Hercher recycled to the back. Still not out of that pack as Oklahoma is setting up a very strong four wall of defense, holding her back, trying to keep her from getting through. 5 points right there for Oklahoma, and here we go, another lead change as we flow. This jam is still in continuous motion, 76-78 Oklahoma.
Singria is now the jammer of record for Jet City, having taken the star pass there from Vana Hercha. But it's check 1-2, getting through with a 5-point pass. Oklahoma City now opening up a little bit. They're out in front by 7 points.
Well, here we go. Oklahoma mounting some score. Another 4 points for check 1-2.
Singria with some ground to make up. Looks like Oklahoma is going to try to set up at the front, getting a little bit closer right now.
Singria making her move, push to the outside by number 21, Esha Spades. Check 1-2 with a little bit of an apex jump. Boom, 5 points out of that pack. The jam is over. 5 more points for Oklahoma. Now we're sitting at 92-80, it looks like right now. Yeah, 92-80. Oklahoma in the lead. 5 minutes and some change left in this first half. We've seen three, if I'm counting right, 3 to 4 lead changes in the past 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm. And I want to thank one of our viewers contacting us using the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. A pronunciation correction on Starter Riot, number 11 for Jet City. Lead jammer status going right now, number 13, that's Ava Durchi. Initial pass completed by T-Pain, jammer for Oklahoma. 14 points though for Ava Durchi.
Well, there we go, holding Oklahoma at zero. Jet City pushing out 584-92.
S1 Helmets, be a lifer, get a lifer. S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets are rad, get rad at S1Helmets.com.
All right, on the fast girl start line for Oklahoma, Polly punching pocket. And whoa, Nelly for Jet City.
Well, Nelly being held up there by Mount Crushmore once again, wearing the pivot stripe right now for Oklahoma, driving jammer out at turn two.
Well, Nelly recycled to the back. That gives an opportunity for Polly Punching Pocket to come out for Oklahoma as the lead jammer.
Bodies are starting to get a little more free and easy here with the movements now, getting the latter stages of this opening half. Starting to see some larger hits. Bodies are starting to wake up. Score is 94 for Oklahoma, 84 for Jet City. 3.5 minutes left on the period clock.
Chicklets Rock and Lethal Lamb on the fast girl start line right now, ready to get it going. 84-94, 3 minutes and change. Jammer whistle is blown.
Lethal Lamb going for the star pass right off the line, drops it, recovers it, and going over the top on the star pass. That's going to hurt. Makes contact at the head. That's a high blocking penalty. Now a power jam for Jet City.
She was trying to pass that star and made contact.
Yep.
Sent to the derbysupply.net penalty box.
Yeah, that's just one of those things. Sometimes you just got to watch it. I mean, obviously not a deliberate attempt to make that contact, but you're just trying to get that star handed off as fast as possible. In the heat of the action, it's going to happen sometimes.
And that's what happened there. Right now, power jam, like you said, Chicklets Rock, Jet City. trying to push her way through on the front line in turn one.
Not a lot of damage as the jammer penalty has already ended. Lethal Lamb back on. That is now the completion of the initial pass. So, you know, nice job there by Oklahoma to negate some of that damage. Only 4 points get scored against them, so they still retain a lead, 94-88, just under 2 minutes left.
Wow, this is an exciting first half that we're starting off. It started off, Oklahoma was on a little bit of a rocky road, and then they just kind of pulled it back. Jet City still holding on, but we've got a very close bout now.
Yeah, so on that fast girl start line, number 14, T-Pain, number 5, Ivana Hercha, wearing the star for Jet City.
Well, here we go. Oklahoma, T-Pain is the lead jammer. Oklahoma controlling the jam in the red. And Ivana Hercha coming out of the pack for Jet City. Obviously not eligible for lead jammer. T-Pain in the pack.
T-Pain goes for a ride over the hips of Assaulted Peanut, calls it from the infield. That's 3 points there. 3 points come in for Oklahoma. T-Pain now 16 points on the day. 7 games in the regular season, T-Pain racking up over almost 300, 285 points.
Wow.
So certainly somebody who's going to be looking to cause a bit more damage in the second half. Looks like we have time for one more in the first. 30 seconds plus on the period clock. Oklahoma 97, Jet City 88. Check 1-2 and Eva Derche coming off the fast girl start line. And a multiplayer block being issued to check 1-2. That's, again, a penalty you don't see super often, but it is being issued right now to check 1-2. So this is now a power jam for Jet City.
Jet City now with an opportunity to bring this score a little bit closer. We're sitting 88-97 as the clock runs down, and we are getting ready to be on the jam clock. She's having a little bit of a trouble getting through that pack. Oklahoma is really setting up a defense to shut this down and hold her at bay. I mean, Eva Derche right in the middle of that in turn four. Tried to make a push for the outside. And that was Mount Crushmore that knocked her a little bit to the outside. Not much of a recycle, but there she is. She finally gets an inside path, and she is out as lead jammer.
Yeah, Mount Crushmore has already shown herself to be quite the mountain to climb in the early going of this game. Back blocking penalty. Actually, no, that's a high block penalty being issued to check 1-2. He takes another seat in that DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Well, here we go. Oklahoma started the game off with some jammer penalties in the first part of this bout, and they're doing it again right here at the very end to Jet City's glee, I guess, as they can bring this score a little closer.
And jam is called. No more time left on the period clock. This should take us to halftime. 4-point edge, Dill, for Oklahoma.
Wow.
Nope, there's the points coming in for Jet City. 1-point edge.
Wow, we have got an official review happening right now from Oklahoma City.
Yep.
It's not over till it's over. We're right now at halftime, but official review got called.
WFTDA, while we're waiting for this review, WFTDA would like to thank DerbySupply.net. Also like to thank Derby City Skates and a Next Level Skate Shop for their participation in this tournament.
Wow, an exciting first half. Like we said, Oklahoma. Oh, here we go.
So they are looking to get a review on an out-of-play blocking call, and we'll see if Lightning Slim can get us a little more information about that. But again, right now we're seeing our score 97-96. Pending anything they may change from this review, which seems unlikely. Oklahoma in the lead right now. As we were saying earlier, this game started with a slew of jammer penalties for Oklahoma. And once they got that nailed down, they started making some noise, seeing some phenomenal blocking. When they get that front wall, like Mount Crushmore, as I was starting to say before, being a very formidable mountain to climb for Jet City. Points so far.
The call will stand.
The call will stand. Points that we're seeing right now, leading scorer for Jet City in the first half, Ava Derche with 27. Looking at 23 for both Polly Punching Pocket and Lethal Lamb wearing the star for Oklahoma.
Well, all right, here we are at halftime, 96-97, Oklahoma bringing it back. They were down in the front, like you said, with the jammer penalties causing them a lot of problems, but then they continually held just a little bit of a gap. They never lost steam, and then they brought it back and got their game together, and here we are, 96-97, Oklahoma in the lead when we come back for this second half. Well, here we go back again. Welcome back to the WFTDA 2015 International WFTDA Division II tournament here in beautiful Cleveland, Ohio.
Yes, we're here at the Cleveland Public Auditorium, which is an absolute gorgeous building. But enough about the architecture. Let's give it a little quick rundown on what's been happening right now coming out of the half. 97 for Oklahoma, 96 for Jet City. Penalty situation, Oklahoma currently only has two skaters who have not taken a single trip to the penalty box. That would be T-Pain and Ace of Spades. Most penalized skater on Oklahoma right now, Jenna Tees, with four trips. On the Jet City side of the ledger, however, we have Starter Riot, who's already taken six trips, and Nasty Nikki Nightstick with five. Nobody else with more than three. Leading point getters thus far in the game overall, it's Ava Derche for Jet City with 27. A couple of 26s for both Chicklets Rock and Woe Nelly. On the Oklahoma City side, leading point getter right now is Polly Punching Pocket with 23 points. Check 1-2 is right up there with 22 points still.
Wow. Yeah, T-Pain with four jams, 16 points, but zero penalties on Oklahoma, and Oklahoma suffering from those penalty jammer penalties that we talked about earlier today, but getting over it in the middle of that first half, a couple more at the end, but right now we're sitting at 96-97 with Oklahoma in the lead. Now the winner of this bout will go on later today to face Santa Cruz Derby Girls at 6 p.m. Game 5 at 6 p.m. Santa Cruz ranked 42 WFTDA and seed 1 in this tournament. Meanwhile, the losers will move on to tomorrow. We'll play it Saturday at noon to an undetermined opponent at this time. We'll find out later on today. So a tall order for the winner of this bout today.
Well, and that Kansas City game could turn out to be very interesting, of course, because all-time Oklahoma Victory Dolls with an 0-1 record against Santa Cruz, but Jet City with an all-time 3-1 advantage against Santa Cruz.
Yeah,
so
this could
we'll
be...
have to see how that one goes.
Yeah, we're going to see... Well, somebody's going to be there, and we're going to see how it goes for sure. Right now, we're sitting at 47 seconds left before we start this derby bout. The
course,
final half.
This is the first playoff weekend of the 2015 International WFTDA playoff season here in Cleveland. Next weekend, the second Division II playoff will be happening in Detroit, Michigan. Not too late to pick up watch passes. Either Division II playoff, they are worth $12, available on WFTDA.tv. So if you're just listening to the free audio coverage right now, it's not too late to get your hands on the viewing pass for that high-quality video feed.
12 easy dollars.
12 easy dollars, that's right. The 12 easiest dollars you will ever spend. of course, the Division I Plus Championship package for $60, also available on WFTDA.tv. So my name is Mr. Whistler.
I'm Dill Hero. We're getting ready to get this underway as we're waiting for the jammer whistle right now. Ava Derche on the line for Jet City in, that, in the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Check 1-2.
Check 1-2.
Starting from a standing position. So that power start doesn't last long.
Oh, wow. Here we go. Cutting the track. Cutting the track is going to send Jet City to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Jammers basically switching positions. Although Oklahoma City was pre-released, they were released out of it.
A star pass now on the Oklahoma City side. Menace, number 82, the pivot, picking up the star. Now the jammer of record for the team in red. Picking her way through that pack. Starter Riot and Ill Ninja have to let her go. And that looks like another penalty going to number 11, Starter Riot.
Well, Oklahoma City taking full advantage with 5 points out of that first pass, scoring another four diving in, and that'll end this jam. 96-102 as we are getting the second half underway. Whoa, Nelly and Polly punching pocket, returning to the fast girls start line. Official timeout.
And yes, that is going to be an early end of the game for number 11, Starter Riot, having fouled out.
Jet City losing Starter Riot, fouling out of the bout. We're sitting in an official timeout. 96-106. Like we say, we're just getting the second half underway. Oklahoma holding it together after a penalty heavy. We keep talking about the jammer penalties in the very beginning, but surprisingly, they're pulling it out. So 106-96, 10 points in their favor.
So Jet City has swapped Ill Ninja into the penalty box. DerbySupply.net penalty box to serve that final penalty that was issued to Starter Riot, number 11.
Jammers waiting patiently on the line. Whoa, Nelly and Polly punching pocket on the fast girls start line. Looks like we're about to get it underway. All clear, whistle blows.
Yeah, Mattis Faction just announcing that there was a quick official timeout there to make some scoreboard adjustments. Score itself, though, still standing at 106-96 in Oklahoma Victory Dolls' favor. Misconduct penalty being issued to number 39, Whoa Nelly, the jammer for Jet City. That'll be that contact with the down blocker for Oklahoma. Power jam and lead jammer status going to Polly punching pocket.
That's the first misconduct that we've seen in this bout. Jet City losing a member, and now that, and looking at Polly punching pocket. Right inside of turn four, cutting to the inside. 5 points right there for Oklahoma.
And just like that, you said that was the first misconduct. The second was just issued to number 80, Beethoven's Fist, who dropped a symphony there on Polly punching pocket at turn three.
Everybody's doing it. Well, here we go. Another 5 points for the Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Polly punching pocket deep in the fray. In the back of that pack, getting pushed to the inside. That'll end this jam with, it looks like, another 4 points for Oklahoma. Zero for Jet City on that pass. We're sitting at 120-96. 27 minutes left in this bout.
Jackson, skate for the love of it. Jackson skates. Thank you, Jackson. Oklahoma now with their largest lead of the game, out front by 24 points.
Yeah, Jet City with a little bit of a shakeup coming out of this, coming into this second half. Oklahoma taking full advantage of it. And here we go. Number three.
Chicklets Rock in the lead right now for Jet City. Meanwhile, number 14, T-Pain, wearing the star for Oklahoma. Jet City in blue, Oklahoma in red. And a massive collision at turn three. we see Chicklets Rock, a couple of blockers, and Zdork all hitting the deck.
Chicklets Rock getting 3 points out of that pileup. .99-120 Oklahoma still holding the lead. Number 46, Fatal Inferno, on the line right now.
Oklahoma starting at the front, stretch out that pack. However, reforms quickly.
Ivana Hirschi for Jet City. Ivana Hirschi is pushed right up to the front. And there is a four wall of Oklahoma victory dolls waiting for her. We have a forearm call right now. It's going to send Fatal Inferno to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and that's going to be a power jam for Ivana Hirschi in Jet City. Recycle to the back, trying to make the most of it.
Yeah, Fatal Inferno had three early jammer penalties in the first half. First trip back with the star since, now taking yet another seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Ivana Hirschi with lead jammer. 45 seconds it took to get a lead jammer status called.
Multiplayer block penalty being issued to number 00, Mount Crushmore for Oklahoma. Big hit on the Oklahoma jammer. That's Fatal Inferno, who is back out on the track.
Meanwhile, Ivana Hirschi coming just from a previous pass of 5 points back into the back of that pack already. It looked like she thought she was called out on a penalty. The jammer ref called her back in. So that is 5 points for Jet City. That was a scary moment in Jet City's bout here. But there was no penalty. She comes back in with 5 points and makes the most of it again, coming out of the pack with 4 points for Jet City. Jet City closing the gap. But Oklahoma pulling out 4 points right there at the end of that jam.
Yeah, the regular season play, Jet City averaging about six jammer penalties a game, already having just exceeded that, trying to stem that damage, though, and keep it from getting any worse on that side of the ledger. If you missed out on your exclusive 2014 Playoffs Championship merchandise, you can complete your collection at the WFTDA online store. The URL for that is, of course, WFTDA.com/store.
All right, we're at an official review now. Official timeout to official review called by Oklahoma.
Of course, coming up next after this game at 2 o'clock Eastern time, which is, of course, where we are at, will be the third game of the tournament. Number 3 seed Columbia taking on the number 6 seed Houston. That'll be at 2 p.m. Eastern time. Let's see if we get some word on this review.
What's about that jammer being called back in? Mm-hmm. Thought there was a penalty. The ref called her back in. The points were scored after that. A lot of points, actually, for Jet City.
Yep. So they are reviewing that as we speak. Having a look there, you can see the whiteboards, and what you're seeing there, of course, is number 11, Starter Riot from Jet City, who did foul out on the first jam of this half. Still a clean ledger, though, for a couple of skaters on the Jet City side. Number 19, the Mexorcist. Number 1, See You Wouldn't Want to Be a. See, you wouldn't want to be as skated in 9 jams, yet to pick up a single trip to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Satisfaction is going to supply a verdict to the captains and bench staff of that review.
Don't forget, you're watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs live here on WFTDA.tv or you're listening in. Don't forget you can buy your passes to watch this. You should buy your passes, if not just to see the beautiful arena.
So the verdict there is that the no call does stand. So no changes to the ledgers as a result of that review. So Oklahoma does not retain their review for this half. We've got 23 minutes and 41 seconds left on the period clock. Oklahoma in red, 124. Jet City in blue, 112. 12-point deficit for the Bombers.
And Jet City coming out of there. Eva Durchi is the lead jammer out on our trail. Lethal Lamb from Oklahoma. Lethal Lamb has been a strong jammer for Oklahoma during this bout, and I believe she was earlier with her team history an alternate.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, putting up some impressive numbers, getting pressed into heavy usage here in this game. On that jam, only point comes in for Jet City. It's a 1-0. So Oklahoma 124, Jet City 113.
Check 1-2 on the Fast Girl start line with Whoa Nelly from Jet City. Four on two right now. Oklahoma stronger in the pack. Jet City with just two. And it shows right there as check 1-2 comes out of that pack as your lead jammer.
Now Crushmore has some nice work on the drawback there on Whoa Nelly. Whoa Nelly now handing the star off to her pivot. Pivot being number 44, Singria. Singria now with the star jammer of record for Jet City.
Well, check 1-2 still just coming off a 5-point pass and deep into the pack once again with another 5-point pass for Oklahoma. Oklahoma creating a gap here away from Jet City, kind of the opposite of what we saw in the beginning of this initial matchup. And there she goes again. Check 1-2 out of the pack. Four more points for Oklahoma. Singria still representing the jammer for Jet City. Not out of the pack yet. Jet City with a four wall right in front, doing a good job of holding her at bay while check 1-2 makes her laps, does her rounds.
Oh, and Singria picking up a low blocking penalty for that last collision, taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Power jam now for check 1-2.
And as we're saying it, check 1-2 comes out of that pack with five more points for Oklahoma.
And she puts the fist in the air like, yes, I know I have a power jam. I got this one.
She's celebrating. And rightfully so. This is a huge jam right now for Oklahoma. And she's at it again, out of the pack with another 5 points. Oklahoma driving that score up to 148, Jet City at 113, 20 minutes and change left in this entire bout.
And I did say in the first half that check 1-2, having put up some really big points in the regular season, we're expecting to see some noise from her in the second half. And just like that, she just did put up 24 on that one jam. And if you'd like to nerd out along at home with the stats repository is available online at stats, I believe that's a hyphen repo, R-E-P-O dot W-F-T-D-A dot com.
Go get you some stats.
Get some stats. Stats.
Right now we're in official timeout. Well, the official timeout is come to an end. All right, Polly Punching Pocket for Oklahoma out of the pack, quick and fast, and she is the lead jammer. Yep. Whoa Nelly representing Jet City. Whoa Nelly recycled to the back of the pack. Looked like number 42 Scarbomb taking a penalty to recycle. Oh, a multiplayer block. Oklahoma still scoring the score, four points for Polly Punching Pocket, Oklahoma Victory Dolls.
Singria still jamming for Jet City.
Wow. Here we go again. Another 4 points from Polly punching pocket. Oklahoma Victory Dolls on a tear these last two jams. We're sitting at 119-156, 19 minutes and change left in this bout. The jam is still ongoing as Polly punching pocket, leaving a pack of devastation as she is trying to push her way through right in turn three. Forearm. Forearm block sends her to the derbysupply.net, so the pack of the devastation I speak of sends her to the penalty box, and that leaves a power jam for Sangria for Jet City. 5 points right now for Jet City, mounting a comeback right here in this situation, taking full advantage. They have four blockers. It's a full four-on-four action right now on the court.
Sia Winwanabia taking out the pivots. Number 85, E-bomb of Oklahoma. Sia Winwanabia along with Chantilly Cream making all sorts of noise at the back of that pack.
Speaking of noise, another 5 points for Jet City. As this jam comes to an end with a 3-point Oklahoma pass right there at the very end, but we're sitting at 134-159. Jet City making the most of that that jammer penalty we just saw.
Indeed. And you can roll faster and farther with Quick Ceramic Bearings. Quick Bearings, when you want quality, think Quick.
Chick Let's Rock for Jet City and T-Pain for Oklahoma. T-Pain is hung up in the front. The packs have their respective. Oh, look at that. Called out for a track cut. Chick Let's Rock is going to the derbysupply.net penalty box, and that leaves Oklahoma in a dangerous situation. Number 14, T-Pain, is now the lead jammer. Tried a little bit of a jump to the inside. There was no apex. She tried to jump around the line, got knocked out, and back into the back of the pack.
She did indeed, Dill. Now T-Pain, those doors get shut on her. Razor Wrecker pushing her teammates into T-Pain, drives to the infield, jam called. Looks like another four come in for Oklahoma. So Oklahoma now opening up. They are now out in front by 29 points with 17 minutes left in the second half, 163-134. Lethal Lamb, let the power start for Oklahoma.
And the jammer whistle is blown. Lethal Lamb is off and running, weaving and dodging inside of Jet City's pack defense.
Again, the tandem of Chantilly Cream and Sia Winwanabia creating all sorts of havoc there for Lethal Lamb, but she does pierce that two-wall.
Well, they held Lethal Lamb just long enough to make it a race, but Lethal Lamb is the lead jammer right now for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Chick Let's Rock back in play, squeezing out 2 points for Jet City. Lethal Lamb won on that last pass.
Don't forget, if you like what you see or have something to say, you can get in touch with us on the Twitters using the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. That's talk and the number two, WFTDA.
Check 1-2 on the line for Oklahoma. And Ivana Hurtcha for Jet City. Both jammers being pushed on the inside. Ivana Hurtcha holding on and still able to stay in the middle, not having to recycle the back now to the front of the pack. Just outside of turn two, she pulls out as the lead jammer. Ivana Hurtcha, Jet City in blue, now controlling the jam.
Razor Wrecker with a Herculean effort there to get check 1-2 over the line and unable to do so. Massive effort also in turn by check 1-2 to withstand that barrage. However, not able to score as 4 points do come in for Jet City on that one.
Mm-hmm. Reva Durche on the line for Jet City, and Polly Punching Pocket returning to the line for Oklahoma Victory Dolls.
Regular season, Polly Punching Pocket averaging 33 points per game.
Wow.
Already with 48 in this one. So Polly Punching Pocket punching above her average right now.
Reva Durche pushed to the outside, recycled to the back just off of the Fast Girl start line. Polly Punching Pocket caught up in the back on turn one, coming out. Oh, a huge hit right there on Eva Durche. Meanwhile, Polly Punching Pocket comes out of that pack and out of that mess as the lead jammer.
See, nasty Mickey Nightstick there in the middle. Genetees doing her darndest to move her aside for her jammer.
All right, and we're seeing a star pass. She took it off. She's going back. Number one, see, you wouldn't want to be ya. Put the jammer star on, took it off, went back, called out, throwing it to the inside. And right now, Polly Punching Pocket in a power jam situation. There's no jammer right now for Jet City.
Well, exactly. See, one wouldn't want to be a leaving it on the track. That was her first penalty of the game.
Wow, and a big one, too.
Unfortunate timing, though, in the middle of that incomplete star pass. So now original jammer, 13, Eva Durche. Coming back to collect it. But that's a whole couple of passes. No points coming in for Jet City.
Yeah, meanwhile, Polly Punching Pocket and the Oklahoma Victory Dogs taking full advantage of that penalty situation and that star pass issue from Jet City.
See, you wouldn't want to be it, though. At the conclusion there, the nice hit on Polly Punching Pocket at turn four, forcing the call off.
140 to 183, 12 minutes and change left in this entire bout. Again, the winner of this bout is going on later today to face off against Santa Cruz Derby Girls, seed one in this Division II tournament.
So right now, 43 roller derby points separating these two teams. Oklahoma in red with that lead.
Wonelli representing Jet City and T-Pain for Oklahoma. T-Pain, as soon as I say it, out of that pack, lead jammer. Oklahoma Victory Dolls lead jammers over and over again during the second half and making the most of it, as you can see, as the score creeps away. We're at a 43-point differential. Oklahoma calling it off with another 3 points, so now we're at a 46-point differential, 140 to 186. 11 minutes left in this bout. You're watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs right here in Cleveland, Ohio. And believe me, you want to buy a pass for this. The games are exciting. We had an exciting game earlier to start this whole thing off, and now we have another exciting game. And just to see the arena, it's beautiful here.
It is indeed, Dill. And we're seeing some beautiful roller derby action right now on the track. Chicklets Rock pushing and pushing that three wall down to a deuce. Multiplayer block being issued to number, yeah, I thought the number 82, Menace. He's gonna take a seat in the derby supply.net penalty box.
Well, Chicklets Rock is now holding that lead jammer status as she is pushing through the front and making the most of it. 4 points. Out of that pack, quick and fast. Hot on the heels of Lethal Lamb, who had came out of that pack, calling off the jam right before Lethal Lamb could get in that pack and get any points. They'll take what they can get right there. Jet City calling it off, 144 to 186. Jet City in blue, Oklahoma Victory Dolls in red.
And we've had the second foul out of the game. Again, it's Jet City. It's number 12, a nasty Nikki Nightstick. Done for the game, off to the locker room.
Nasty Nick the Nightstick, huge blocker advantage Jet City had, is now gone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, doing some phenomenal work in the first half and in the second, and Jet City now down to 12 skaters for the duration.
We'll see how it's going to play out. Oklahoma right now, check 1-2, representing for Oklahoma, and Ivana Hercha for Jet City. Check 1-2, jumping the line, getting past the pack, and she is now the lead jammer. Oklahoma once again controlling the jam. That's their thing in the second half.
It is indeed, and again, Mount Crushmore at the center of all of that seismic activity at the front of the pack.
Well, 4 points and a call off real quick. Oklahoma right now sitting at 190, Jet City 144.
Saw on that last pass, Mount Crushmore and Genetees, two of the blockers up front for Oklahoma, Victory Dolls. And Jet City pretty much deciding to target Mount Crushmore, take her out of that equation, and that allowed their jammer to get through on that final pass.
Fast girl start line right now. We're seeing number 13, Eva Durche for Jet City, and T-Pain for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Jet City out of that pack first, and Eva Durche is the lead jammer. Cutting the track is going to send T-Pain from Oklahoma Victory Dolls to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. And then we have an immediate, another cutting the track right away from Eva Durche, sending her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. And it's going to be a release of the jammers. Release of Oklahoma City jammer immediate. And Jet City's not going to spend long in that penalty box either. So let's just pretend it never happened.
Ill Ninja with a nice takeout there on T-Pain, colliding with Seizure, the jammer ref, on the way back. Nice open space there. If I see lanes 1 and 2, you know I'm taking one of them, and that's exactly what Ava Durche just did.
Yeah, there was zero resistance there, but she made her own path there, a little bit windier of a road right there in turn 3, but she still made it through untouched. 5 points for Jet City. Eva Durche closing the gap.
Meanwhile, E-Bomb, who is now the jammer of record for Oklahoma, takes those same two open lanes after receiving that star pass to complete hers. Twirls around at turn 4. Again, Ill Ninja laying the lumber.
Like I said, E-Bomb in turn 4 recycled to the back, and we have a 4 wall of Jet City trying to stop her pass. Meanwhile, Eva Durche from Jet City, 5 more points on that last pass, and she's already back in the pack, the 2 wall of Oklahoma, trying to shut her down. She gets through. Looks like another 4 points
nice
for Jet City.
It's a very nice toe-stop work there by Ebom on the outside. Does not go over the line. But Jet City makes a dent in this Oklahoma lead. It's now down to 26 really big points. We've got 6 minutes left. We need to see Jet City to get back into this. They're going to need to get some big points on each and every one of these following jams.
You're right. 6 minutes and change left on the bout clock, the game clock. We were starting with a 40-some point deficit in the beginning for Jet City, and now we're merely sitting at 26, like you said.
And a scoreboard adjustment. 2 points come off the board for Oklahoma, so that lead is actually 24. But so what we've seen thus far in this game, it's not common for Oklahoma in this game to give up that many points in one jam. So Jet City, I think, is going to have to start chiseling away at this one on this one. So they're sending out Woe Nelly to the Fast Girls start line, number 39. Woe Nelly thus far, 28 points for the Bombers.
Well, Woe Nelly is working her magic on that two-wall pack, a little bit of assistance, and just outside of turn 2, had to let her go. Lead jammer for Jet City, Woe Nelly now controlling the jam.
And she is the only jammer, as E-Bomb did start this one in the DerbySupply.net penalty box for a penalty incurred at the end of the previous jam. So taking advantage Wonelli
once again pushing the pack limits for Oklahoma City, and the last line of defense forced to let her go. 4 points on that last pass for Jet City.
And four more.
Wow.
Well-timed call off there for Wonelli. Just like that, folks, this lead is what I said. They have to start making a dent in that lead right now. They did exactly that. Put up 8 points on that one. They're down only by 16.
Sitting at a timeout right now.
So right now it looks like Phelan Furno will be returning to the Fast Girls start line on this one for Oklahoma. And as I say that, teammate Check 1-2 comes over, collects the jammer star. Check 1-2, second leading point getter in this game for Oklahoma. It's got 50 thus far.
Well, here we go. It's 4 minutes and 58 seconds. This bout is coming to a close. 180 to 196. We've seen several lead changes at the end of the first half. It went back and forth a little bit. Oklahoma running away with it a little bit in the second half. But Jet City doing a great job of catching up here in the last few jams. Chick, let's rock on the line and Check 1-2. Representative Check 1-2 out of that pack for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. She is the lead jammer. Well, that pack is flying around the track. Oklahoma setting the pace.
Now Crushmore picking up on the fact that there is a jammer cover in the hand of Chicklets Rock, warning people about the possible panty pass. That's what you heard her screaming from the track. And indeed, her teammates target Chicklets Rock, force the penalty on her, and it's now a power jam for Oklahoma.
Well, Check 1-2 in a dangerous position right now with the power jam situation. Oklahoma already in the lead. The clock is counting down 4 minutes and change. No, it's actually down to 3 minutes and some change. 180 to 201. The jam is still in play. Five more points right there for Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Check 1-2.
So Oklahoma calls it before the penalty to Chicklets Rock fully expires. That's going to allow them to send out Polly Punching Pocket, number KO with the star for the Fast Girls dart line on this power start. And Polly Punching Pocket, currently the leading point getter in this entire game, 67 points over seven jams. And there it is. You kind of knew that Strychnine was about to call that timeout. He's starting to work the clock for Oklahoma Victory Dolls.
Yep, trying to hold on to this lead they've gained in the second half.
Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. FSX wheels, the hottest wheels in the market, Quadstar certified and cutting edge technology. MyBontz, the latest and greatest way to customize your Bontz skates at Bontz.com.
And ladies and gentlemen, don't forget you're watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II playoffs here in Cleveland, Ohio. Coming up after this bout, you can see the Columbia Quad Squad taking on the Houston Roller Derby. That game starts at 2 o'clock our time, Eastern time.
And looking much further ahead, the 2015 International WFTDA Championships going to kick off on November 6th, where the preeminent teams in the WFTDA Division I will come together to fight for the sport's greatest honor, the Hydra. Of course, also the top four Division II teams will also go head-to-head in the D2 Championship and third-place games November 6th to 8th at the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium in St. Paul, Minnesota.
All right, here we go, Polly Punching Pocket. The only jammer on the track as we speak in Turn 2, knocked to the outside, recycled. And as I say it, Chicklets Rock released from the penalty box and is now in play. Neither one of these jammers has made it out for their first pass yet.
Chicklets Rock almost had that four wall push far enough out. Couldn't escape, though.
Well, each team individually doing a great job of setting defense and holding both jammers. But as I say that right there, Polly punching pocket. Finds a little bit of a gap, but takes a trip, falls down. But she's still lead jammer, even though she's back in the pack. Originally, she has taken the lead jammer status.
And while Beethoven's Fist is being an incredible nemesis right now for Polly punching pocket, tragedy striking for Jet City. Another jammer penalty. Chicklets Rock taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Ill-timed power jam being given up to Oklahoma, and Polly Punching Pocket, who knows what to do with all this track space.
Well, Polly Punching Pocket and Sangria facing off in the past two laps that they have intertwined, but another 5 points for Polly Punching Pocket. Oklahoma Victory Dolls setting a huge gap as the clock counts down, 1:42 on the official clock. Oklahoma right now in a strong position. Jet City not wanting to see this. We started off Oklahoma with a huge amount of jammer penalties, and it seems that Jet City taking up the jammer penalty flag, if you will, towards the end here.
Polly Punchy Pocket calls that one from outside between turns 3 and 4. Call that turn 3.5. She has put up now 80 points for the Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Easily the leading scorer in this game at this point. A minute left on the period clock. Power start for Oklahoma, number 28, Lethal Lamb.
Lethal Lamb has put up 21 points during this bout. And again, from what I've read, she came up from backup crew, basically, and doing a good job, having a good show here at the tournament. She is now lead jammer for Oklahoma Victory Dolls.
And now in the driver's seat with only just under 30 seconds left, just has to run this one down to zero and make the call if she can stay clean. Big hit there at number 31, Chantilly Cream, basically hydroplanes into the infield.
Well, Jet City back in play. 5 points right now for Jet City, Ivana Hercha. The official game clock has run out. We're running on the jam clock right now. Jet City making the most of it. Ivana Hercha coming out of a 5-point pass and back in the pack. Just outside of turn two. At a dead standstill, three wall right there. Oklahoma Victory Dolls holding Ivana Hercha at bay. Ivana Hercha.
Clock has hit zero. Oklahoma, though, is going to keep going right now.
Yep, keep running that jammer clock right now. Mount Crushmore have given Jet City a lot of problem. Ivana Hercha with another pass through and another 5 points.
Still a lot of ground to make up, though. They're at 190. Whistles are going. That is going to do it. During that last jam, we actually saw Chicklets Rock foul out as well. That's the third for Jet City in this game.
Wow, Jet City with a lot of penalty trouble in the second half of this bout. It was flip-flopped. Oklahoma started off that way, and we're setting an unofficial score right now. 222 for Oklahoma Victory Dolls and 190 points for Jet City.
And one thing I do want to say is, like, I do find it a little curious. Jet City ends that game not only with that last official review available to them, but also they had two timeouts at their disposal, not using either of those in the late going.
Wow, here we go. Final score, like I said, Oklahoma Victory Dolls from Oklahoma City coming out of this, the win at 222 points. They're going to go on later today to face seed one, WFTDA ranked number 42, Santa Cruz Derby Girls. Jet City coming out of this, 190, Jet City from Everett, Washington. They'll go on tomorrow to play an undetermined team at noon, game eight tomorrow, Saturday at noon. We had three penalty foul outs on Jet City. No penalty foul outs on Oklahoma, although Mount Crushmore was very, very close.
In fact, so close she just over the edge with her seventh.
She's so close she went out.
That's right.
So, yeah, anyway, there it is. Mount Crushmore was sent out on a penalty, fouled out of this.
Something I'd like to call your attention to also, Ace of Spades, number 21 for Oklahoma, skates in 24 jams, not a single trip to that penalty box.
There's got to be some kind of award for that.
Yeah, the only skater on Oklahoma, actually, who skates the entire box penalty-free.
Well, in a bout like this, a physical bout like this, with the penalties flying and the way they were playing, that's very impressive. Yeah. No penalties.
Yep. Again, Polly Punching Pocket finishing with 80 points, leading score for Oklahoma. Avidarchi, 56 for Jet City in a losing cause.
All right. Well, I'd like to thank you. I'm Dill Hero, and this is Mr. Whistler. Thank you so much for tuning in to the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs here in Cleveland, Ohio. Plenty of more great bouts coming up this afternoon. And for Mr. Whistler, I'm Dill Hero. Thanks for tuning in, WFTDA.TV.